Hello and welcome to this new episode of Free Science 365. Today, in the spirit of learning during this quarantine period, we're going to talk about the states of matter. Now, generally speaking, we are taught only three states of matter. First, we have solids, then we have liquids, and finally, we have gases. A basic example will be a block of ice. Now, a block of ice is very hard, and it's called a solid. Now, if you give some energy to this block of ice, it melts, and when it melts, it changes into water, liquid water. So that's the second state of matter, liquid. And if you further give some heat or some kind of energy to a liquid, for example, in case of water, it changes into water vapors, gases. Today, we are going to expand our understanding of the states of matter. In total, there are 42 states of matter. But today, we are going to focus on five. So what's beyond gas and what's beyond solids? That's basically what we're going to talk about. Now, mind you, in the ice, the water, and the water vapor, the molecule of water, H2O, has not broken down. Water remains the same water. The state of the matter changes from solid to liquid to gas, but what does not change is the structure of the water molecule. Now, what is plasma? Plasma is the state of matter when the molecule actually breaks down. The positive hydrogen ion and the negative oxygen ions, they break. And once the bond is broken, there's no more water left. All you have left is hydrogen and oxygen ions, and a lot of subatomic particles are also flowing around. When you break things down from the molecular or atomic structure, a stable structure, to these ionic forms, this highly ionized form is called plasma. One good example that you can see around yourselves is the sun. A lot of hydrogen ions collide together to form helium. It brings about a cloud of ions, and this cloud of ions in a very high concentration in a confined space is what we call plasma. Now, interestingly, you can actually make plasma in your home using a microwave oven and grapes. But we'll do that experiment in some other video. And now, so far, we covered solid, liquid, gas, and plasma. What happens if you keep on cooling things further down? Well, you might think nothing much happens, but in reality, that's where the fifth state of matter comes into being. And this fifth state of matter has a long name. It's called Bose-Einstein Condensate. Now, what is Bose-Einstein Condensate? So, condensate is when you cool something down. For example, when you condensate water vapors, you get water, liquid water. So, condensate is cooled down. Now, we have two names in there, Bose and Einstein. Einstein is the same Einstein that we know, the Einstein. Bose is another scientist who created the quantum statistics. Now, that's another big word. What is quantum statistics? Now, we all know quantum mechanics. But in the early days, in 1920s, scientists were having a real struggle trying to describe the nature of quantum particles. But they were failing. You had Niels Bohr and other scientists were trying very hard to statistically explain the quantum nature of light. And there was this guy from India, a reader in Dhaka University. Dhaka is now the capital of Bangladesh, but back in the day, in 1924, it was part of India. And in 1924, S.N. Bose was playing with these equations derived about quantum nature of photons. And he devised a new statistics, which we now call quantum statistics. And he could count the photons using his statistics in a much better way than the existing classical statistical method. He was thrilled, so he sent his paper to PhilMag. Now, PhilMag was the science magazine of its time. So he sent it to PhilMag in England, but they didn't publish it. They returned it to him saying, no, we cannot publish it, and there was no reason cited. Now, Bose understood instinctively it might be some racism, some kind of British supremacy over Indians. We don't know, but he understood it. So he sent his paper to Einstein. Now think about it, an unknown physics reader, he's not even a lecturer in Dhaka University, writes a paper, and he then sends it to Einstein, the most famous scientist in the world, and he says, Look, I don't know much of German, but I'm the guy who actually translated your theory of relativity into English in India, and we spread your discovery in India. And I have this new method, and please look at it. And if you think it's good, please translate it to German, and please publish this paper. Now think about it for a second. If S.N. Bose did not have the courage and conviction, this crazy optimism that Einstein, the greatest scientist in the world, would listen to him, there is a very high chance that we would not have the Bose-Einstein condensate, the fifth state of matter today. But anyway, so he writes to Einstein. Now Einstein understood it and he said, this is brilliant. And he wrote back to S.N. Bose saying, this is an amazing work, thank you. Einstein translated this statistical work into German and published in a German magazine. In the name of Bose, in 1924, S.N. Bose was 30 years old, and overnight S.N. Bose becomes famous in the physics fraternity, and he is given the permission to go to Europe. So he goes to Paris first, he works with a bunch of scientists, including Madame Curie, the first and the only woman to win two Nobel Prizes, two separate fields of studies, chemistry and physics. And then he goes to meet his hero, Albert Einstein, and Einstein told him, well, I knew that classical statistics couldn't fit my model. My photons needed your statistics. Now, Einstein goes a step further and he says, you know what, Bose's statistics is not only applicable to photons, but also it's applicable to everyday atoms. And he then takes it forward into the realm of atoms. And then he says, we can derive theoretically this new state of matter. And Einstein then worked with S.N. Bose, and Bose-Einstein condensate as a fifth state of matter was theorized, and then it was published. Now, last experiment, we talked about limits in universe. We talked about Planck's length, we talked about Planck's time, we talked about the speed of light. So there are actually limits on things in the universe. Similarly, there is a limit to how cool can we make something. And that limit is 0 Kelvin. So that's the minimum temperature we can achieve. But in reality, we have never achieved 0 Kelvin. We have achieved a millionth, even a billionth of 0 Kelvin, but we cannot achieve 0 Kelvin temperature. It's an absolute truth that temperature-wise, things cannot go south of minus 273 degrees Celsius. So imagine, in a gas, the atoms are just playing around, like children in a playground. They're just running about anywhere they want, they are free to move, they have a lot of energy. Now, if you cool things down, what happens is they become less and less active. Now, as you keep decreasing the temperature further down and down and down, the atoms start depicting a wave-like nature, and they start behaving more like waves, like small waves, but independent small waves. Like you have small waves in the ocean. When you keep decreasing the temperature, these wave-like motions of the atoms become more and more prominent. And then, as you bring the temperatures further down, what happens is all these atoms, they start forming a big one wave kind of thing. Because as you bring the temperature further and further down, the wave nature becomes bigger and bigger. And as soon as the wave becomes bigger than the diameter of an atom, these waves start merging into each other. They get confused. They can't understand. They cannot keep their independent identity. This is so strange, but it has been observed. So that's what happens. All these atoms convert into waves, and these waves convert into this big super wave, and it starts behaving as if it's not independent different atoms, but a kind of a super atom. All atoms, all of them, they combine together and they become one. And that is super fantastic. Now, we can now bring our temperatures down to very near to 0 Kelvin, and we can actually see this happening with certain gases. And that helps us understand superconductivity. Now, back in the day, 1924, a lot of people said it's impossible to achieve 0 Kelvin, absolute zero temperatures, so it's not gonna be realized in real life. Even though J.C. Bose was nominated for a Nobel Prize, he never got the Nobel Prize. But, for example, Higgs boson in 2013. Higgs was the guy who received the Nobel Prize in 2013. The boson is named after Bose. And also, 70 years after the Bose-Einstein condensate was derived, two scientists won the Nobel Prize in physics because they realized the Bose-Einstein condensate in real. It took 70 years, but it was shown to the world that not only is it possible, it's actually very important for us because there is a limit to non-quantum computing. And I think we have hit that limit. Transistors cannot become smaller than they already are. And so what we need is we need a thrust into a new direction. We need a new type of computing. And that computing, many are saying, is going to be quantum computing. So it's very important. Quantum computers need a lot of cooling to operate. So it is a reality. It's not just theoretical physics. But further down, when we go deeper into quantum computing, the speed of calculations is mind-boggling. What a supercomputer now needs to crunch for
10,000 years
can be done with a quantum computer in one day. So just imagine, we will be able to predict weather more precisely. We can do scientific discoveries, we can find medicines, we can discover new materials much, much faster. We can analyze things much, much faster if we have the quantum computers. So that's the implications of Bose-Einstein condensate. So today we'll just conclude with these five states of matter. And if you want me to do the experiment on how to create the fourth state of matter, i.e. plasma, in your home, just with a microwave oven, let me know in the comment section. If someone requests, I will definitely do that. Thank you for watching. And as always, please like, subscribe, comment, and I will see you in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.